Hey guys, it's Keezy here today, and today we'll be looking at the next installment of my costume ball restyles, and that is Miss Eliza McFee. Alright guys, so we're going to start out like we usually do. We're going to start out with unboxing the dolls. And of course, like I say, I always use my little X-Acto knife and my scissors to snip the doll out from the back. Just so I can make sure I don't cut the hair or cut the clothes or anything like that. And with these dolls only coming with one outfit, I can afford to cut her first and only outfit, if you know what I'm saying. Alright, so all the costume dolls come with this invitation to the costume ball. I wish we knew what it looked like. We don't even know what the costume ball looked like, what was happening there. We don't know any of that stuff, so yeah, but you get an invitation, so put on your costumes, get ready. First, we'll start with Eliza's accessories. These are her wings. I really like these wings for the most part. I like the material that they're made out of. They're really iridescent. I love that the color shifts and it looks different depending on what angle you're looking at. The straps, not so much. Not too crazy about them. And these are her earrings. These are super cute. They make her ears look really pointy. And I feel like it'd be a nice piece of jewelry if it was a real life piece. And Eliza's shoes. So she has some sparkly pumps with kind of like a pyramid heel. They have some molded on, it looks like what would be bows. Yeah, these are really cute and they go really well with her outfit. Next, we'll take a look at Eliza's dress. It's this cute A-line short dress that has some sewn on flowers with pearls in the middle. It also has some embroidered words on it. I believe it says School of Shadow according to some other people's translations. It also has a couple of different tiers. So it has this really iridescent fabric right underneath the first kind of layer of tulle. And then she also has a cage skirt. Mine actually came with one of the stitches already like out. And right underneath the cage skirt, she has this kind of satin skirt to give her a little bit of modesty. And this is what Eliza's hair looks like out of box. It is crunchy in some spots, which is typical for MGA, but she does have two tendrils that kind of come down towards her bangs. And her hair is a mix of white with some blue streaks towards the front. Next, we'll take a look at Eliza's makeup. She has kind of a navy eyeshadow that is encompassed with some black graphic liner and then a pink kind of shadow in the crease. She also has some lighter blue shadow on her inner corners. Her lip is supposed to be a gradient, but it didn't really work out that way. And then she has like some holographic shimmer on her cheeks for blush. And now that we've looked at what Eliza comes with, let's freestyle some hair. Alright guys, so today won't be like a tutorial style video. Everything that I'm going to be doing in this restyle, I already have a tutorial up for. So today we're just going to hang out, restyle some hair. Of course, I'm going to walk you guys through the process like I always do. It just won't have any new content as far as, you know, what I'm doing. I'm going to be doing the same process I always do. So I'm going to start out by rinsing her hair, which actually is a little bit different. Look at you. I just lied. So instead of soaking the hair this time, I did decide that I wanted to use cold water to rinse out some of that gel. Again, she only really had gel at the end of her hair for some reason. She didn't really need it because it's not really holding any style in. I mean, her hair was a little bit wavy out of box, but of course, I'll be putting some more waves in a little bit later. So as usual, of course, I'm going to wash the doll's hair. Of course, I'm going to use my Suave clarifying shampoo. And I just chose this shampoo because it's a pretty inexpensive shampoo. And also, clarifying shampoo is actually supposed to be a little bit harsher than regular shampoo. And I think that Rainbow High dolls really need that so you can get out that crunchy gel that's in the hair. And then, of course, after I'm done washing, I'm just going to rinse everything out to get rid of all the shampoo. And once I rinse out the hair, I'm going to use my Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine Conditioner to smooth out her hair and give it a good detangle. This also puts a little bit of moisture in the hair. Like I said in some of my previous videos, the Garnier Sleek and Shine Conditioner is really, really good for coating the hair. And anytime you were going to do any curls or any heat styling with your dolls, you definitely want to put some moisture in it beforehand, in my opinion. And once I've given Eliza's hair a good comb, I'm going to leave her for an hour to 30 minutes to sit. All right, and once the conditioner's had a chance to marinate, I'm going to rinse out her hair to make sure to get some of that excess conditioner out for the styling process. Okay, so for Eliza, I kind of sort of had a plan of how I wanted to style her hair. I knew that I wanted to change those kind of rubber banded twists that she originally had into actual braids. My overall vibe I wanted to give Eliza was just more of kind of that ethereal fairy look. So I wanted to give her some actual braids, and that's what I'm going to do. So I'm basically going to create a braid crown. I wish I could explain to you exactly how to do the braids, but basically all it is a French braid, and I did that on each side of her hair. So I just braided it all the way down, and eventually I'm going to tie it back to kind of create that crown look. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now, is just creating those braids on both sides of her head. I also want to mention, I did create a braid right next to her ear as well that I will pull back in some later clips. So if you're ever wondering how to create braids like this, what I did was just watch YouTube videos right here as you know, you're doing right now. I am not an expert braider by any means. I don't even know how I learned how to do this because I can't even do this on my own hair. So yeah, my dolls get a better treatment than I do, and that's okay. But I don't know that I mentioned while doing the braids, I did also leave two tendrils out as well. So I kind of left a tendril that's really close to her bangs that you'll see later, and another one that is going to be right beside the braid. And later what I'm going to do is curl those pieces again, just to kind of give her that look, kind of like ethereal, like organic, kind of lived in hair look. I hope that makes sense to you guys, but that's what I did. And yeah, I had to cut some of her bangs as well because they weren't thatched very well. She had a piece that kept wanting to come down, so I had to cut it, and you can see it sticking up. But I do fix that a little bit later. Okay, and once I've completed Eliza's two braids for her braid crown, I'm going to go ahead and proceed to curling the tendrils that I told you I created in the front. And this is actually the same technique that I just used on my Laguna Blue video, so I will definitely link that in the cards above if you'd like to see that. But yeah, it's the exact same process. It's super easy. I'm just using a straw to curl the hair and then using a slit open straw to cover it and secure the hair down. Alright, and once I have properly curled the hair, what I'm going to do is do a boil wash to set in those curls. Alright, and after the curls have been set, this is what Eliza looks like. So, of course, she has her little braids that I did. This is what her hair looks like before. We're gonna do a little bit of waving to it. But those tendrils, they turned out okay. I did have to touch them up later, to be honest. But overall, I think it's still a good look. Thank you. as I stated, so the last process for styling her hair is I'm just going to give her some waves. Again, this all kind of goes for that kind of ethereal, like fairy look. I don't know why the first thing I thought of when, you know, I thought of Eliza being a fairy is, you know, just some waves. And I mean, it's probably not that revolutionary that I thought about it because, again, in box, she did have a little bit of a wave to her hair, but I really wanted to kind of amp it up. That's honestly what my channel is all about. Like, I want to show you guys how to just take your dolls kind of to the next level, not necessarily make it your doll look completely different, you know, unless that you want to do that. But yeah, that's why I decided to do waves, because I think that it just kind of gives that kind of organic, kind of just lived in look. And when I think of fairies, I think of just like really natural, really kind of like organic looks, because, you know, they live outside. Maybe I'm overthinking that. Maybe I'm the only person that has like that type of thought process. But hey, I mean, I wanted to tell you guys why I decided to do this. And honestly, this restyle is probably one of my more intricate ones. I mean, it's not super difficult to do, especially if you know how to do some braids. But for me, this is, you know, a lot different from what I normally do, especially for like my core dolls. Now, when I do get like doubles or duplicates of my dolls, I do like to do more of an in-depth restyle. And yeah, just let me know in the comments, guys. Do you want to see more intricate restyles from me? I can do them. I just typically don't, because I don't know, I'm just kind of into simple hairstyles. Now, if you want to get some really, really good restyles and some super intricate, super detailed restyles, I 100%, I mean, if you're already here, you probably already know about him, but I definitely recommend watching Rodney Rainbow, because his restyles are on a whole other level. Me, I just kind of like to do more kind of simple restyles. So yeah, but let me know what you guys think. Would you like to see some maybe more detailed restyles here and there? Swear when we're together, heaven's on the ground. I'll do this forever looking at you now. I can't get enough. I don't know how you did it, boy. You got me spinning around your bedroom. Touch me like the sun touches the morning. Looking, you could read me like a story. Controlling all of my thoughts, I want you on my body. Turning me on, baby, you know you got me. Got me tripping over all of these lines, I can't lie, yeah. Spinning down, head over my heart, turning inside out. Love me in the dark, looking at you now. I can't get enough when you touch me like. Heaven's on the ground. I'll do this forever looking at you now. All right, and this is what Eliza looks like after getting her hair all waved. I love using my waver on my nylon girls. It just looks so good. And we're almost done with our hair, I promise. So what I'm gonna do next is tie back the two bigger braids to kind of create that crown look. I don't show it in this clip because I actually did it off camera, but the two small braids next to her ears, I did end up pulling those back as well. See, I test it out, but I never actually do it. But I do end up doing it a little bit later. And then after that, I'm going to put a little bit of hairspray in her bangs to keep them down. And then there's one more step. So I created these flower headpieces for Eliza. Don't hate me because I didn't film it. I just wasn't super confident that it was gonna turn out good. So I didn't film it, but they do secure into her head with some pins that I cut down. And yeah, I think this just adds to that overall fairy vibe. I mean, a fairy can never have too many flowers, right? And I mean, they need their crown. All right, guys, and that is all for my restyle of Eliza McFee. I really love the way that this turned out. I think that I really kind of did what I was looking to do, which was give her a little bit more of a fairy vibe, especially with the hairstyle. I think the braids look super nice. I love kind of the two-tiered look. And of course, the waves turned out really well. I really recommend using a waver if you ever want to get this type of texture on your doll hair. Of course, she's not wearing her wings because I wanted to find a way to secure them to her without using those hideous straps. And of course, I do like the flower crown as well. I wanted to play off of some of those pinks and purples that are in her makeup. So yeah, that's all I have for you guys today though. If you feel like it, please like, comment, and of course, subscribe. And I will see you guys later for the next video. So the way that I was patient, 'cause you calling me. So different, but I'm never